The Alien franchise is one that lends itself well to the world of video games. From the Atari 2600 to the modern consoles and PCs of today, Alien games over the years have been lucky enough to score more hits than misses. The latest entry on its way into the series is Aliens Fireteam, and the early footage has many of us counting the days until it finally gets released. In the meantime, the people over at Cold Iron Studios, courtesy of IGN, have given us some brief looks at some of the aliens that we can expect to encounter, and today we'll be taking a closer look at the Burster and Spitter Xenomorph variants. We'll begin with the Burster alien. These are the Xenos that are most commonly found with runner aliens during the first mission of Aliens Fireteam. The file on the Burster reads as follows. Though they generally behave like runners, Bursters are more dangerous. When slain, their bodies explode into a lethal pool of acid. The species they gestate within is not yet known, but likely indigenous to, with the word redacted, meaning they aren't telling us just where yet. In short, don't kill them up close. The Burster Xenomorph moves a lot like your common runner alien, moving quickly on all four legs. Similar to the runners, the Bursters also use their bladed tails as a weapon and pounce when in close, using their teeth and claws to tear at their victims. Like other higher tier Xenos, tend to hunt within packs of runner aliens, allowing them to get in close enough to render the most damage if they're taken out. Beyond looking like a runner variant, the Bursters of Aliens Fireteam also bear a resemblance to the boiler Xenos of Aliens Colonial Marines. The boilers were bipedal, but that's just a host difference, yet they both employ a defensive measure of exploding into a shower of deadly acid when attacked. Now I should note that the Bursters look like a healthy alien strain, whereas the boilers seem to be older and/or showing effects of radiation exposure. Both aliens have the trademark acid sacs all over them, and they both seem to have a lighter colored exoskeleton than other Xenomorphs. At least in the game footage seen so far, the Bursters seem to be your entry level of the higher tier of Xenomorph, sitting directly above the runners. Strangely enough, the head of the Burster actually looks like some of the various heads available to the Spitters in the customization area in Aliens Colonial Marines. The next alien to appear in Aliens Fireteam is the Spitter alien. Looking to the information given to us from IGN, the file on the Spitters reads as follows. Unusually, Xenomorph spitters prefer to keep distance between themselves and their prey. Though they have vicious claws and teeth, they dispatch most foes by projecting streams of powerful acid from glands in their mouth. This is Dennis Nedry's least favorite Xenomorph. The spitter aliens seem to be the next advancement of alien seen in Aliens Fireteam after the Bursters. It also appears that the spitters and other bipedal aliens that you encounter in the game, at least from what we've seen in the footage so far, are much bigger than a human, and maybe even a bit taller than other representations of these types of aliens in other media. I will admit though that the size does help out with their intimidation factor. Like the Burster variants, the Spitters will tend to hide amongst groups of runners, possibly for protection. These guys resemble the Neomorphs and some of their concept images from the Alien prequels, with their heads having a flatter shape than their standard Xeno cousins, along with the back of the head tapering down into a point. They are, however, darker than the Neo in color, with acid sacs visible in the neck area. However, the dorsal spines that we see on pretty much all other bipedal Xenotypes seem to be replaced with what looks like spines, another trait of the Neomorphs. Like other higher tier Xenomorph classes seen so far in Aliens Fireteam, the Spitters have a stronger armor than the Runner and Burster variants, making them a difficult alien to take down in any wave of alien attackers. And if the name of this variant seems familiar, it is. A spitter alien was also encountered in the video game Aliens Colonial Marines. There they had larger head crests, more similar to the Praetorians, and acid sacs in their ribcage. They also used a similar method of attack, but instead of hiding within packs of runner aliens, they tended to group up with other spitter xenomorphs. And that is it for the Burster and Spitter Xenomorphs of Aliens Fireteam. Now there were 6 classes in total detailed in the IGN release. I've already covered the runners and the bursters, so we'll take a look at the drones and the Praetorians in another video. Thanks for watching guys, your likes, shares, comments, and subscriptions go a long way towards helping the channel grow. Take care, and I hope to see you next time.